Hello friends, welcome to my channel sonisinghphysics. In this video I am going to talk about mechanics paper 4-2. I have taken one question based on forces. Along with this question I will also discuss some important terms which is useful in mechanics. That is going to be very useful for you in the examination. Friends, if you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. I have one request from you. Please suggest me some topics which I can focus in my next video. You can send your suggestion either in the comment or through my email ID. I have written my email in the description. So friends, let us move to the question. This is the question which I am going to discuss now. The first two questions of this paper I have discussed in my previous video. If you want to see that, you can click on the I button so you can get the link from there. Before I discuss this question, I want to share some very important points regarding mechanics with you. These are the terminology which we use in mechanics 1 and these are very important as per exam point of view. The first one is particle. What is the meaning of particle? A particle is a body whose entire weight acts through a single point. A particle doesn't suffer from air resistance. So here is our concern, a particle does not suffer from air resistance. The second one is uniform. A body is said to be uniform if it has constant density. The third important point is smooth. A smooth surface is one which has no friction. Then the fourth one is a rough. A rough surface is one upon which friction acts, means it has friction. Next one is light. Light means if an object is light, means it has no mass, so no weight acts on a light body. The next one is inextensible string. It is the string which has fixed length. It is impossible to stretch. So stretching is not possible in inextensible string. The next one is a rigid body. It is a body which is not a point and whose shape is fixed. Now move on to the question. The question is, a particle P of mass 0.3 kg is held in equilibrium above a horizontal plane by a force of magnitude 5 Newton. So this is 5 Newton force which is held vertically above on the particle. The particle is attached to two strings PA and PB of length 0.9 meter and 1.2 meter respectively. So these are the two strings. The first one is 0.9 meter and the second one is 1.2 meter. The point A and B lie on the plane and angle APB is equal to 90 degrees. So this is the angle APB that is equal to 90 degrees. Since I have done the forces, you can't see it properly, but I have done another diagram here. So we will see the component force over here neatly. Find the tension in each strings. So the question is, we have to find the tension in the string AP and string BP. So I have just taken this diagram over here. This angle is 90 degrees. Now we'll see the component of this T1 and T2. This we can consider theta 1. And this we can consider theta 2. So the horizontal component of T1 will be T1 cos theta 1 and for T2 it will be T2 cos theta 2. The vertical component of T1 will be T1 sin theta 1 and for T2 it will be T2 sin theta 2. There is another vertical force which is working directly opposite to 5 Newton, that will be Mg. So there are two forces working horizontally, T1 cos theta 1 and opposite to that will be T2 cos theta 2 and vertically against 5 Newton there are three forces, that is T1 sin theta 1, T2 sin theta 2 plus Mg. After doing the components of forces T1 and T2, the next task is we have to find the value of this hypotenuse. Since it is a right angle triangle and the value of opposites and adjacent are given there, So we'll find the value of hypotenuse with the help of Pythagoras' theorem. So as per that theorem, r will be equal to root under 1.2 square plus 0.9 square. And when we will solve it, we'll get the value r will be equal to 1.5 meter. Now we'll find out the value of sine theta 1, cos theta 1, sine theta 2 and cos theta 2, because we are going to use these angles in our further questions. Sine theta 1 will be equal to 4 by 5. The formula for sine theta I have given here, that is opposite by hypotenuse, and cos theta will be equal to adjacent by hypotenuse. So by using this formula, we'll get the value of all these. After finding the values of all the angles, our next task is to see the vertical components and horizontal components. Friends, you can solve this question with me. So vertical component, as you have seen before, that the 5 is equal to t1 sine theta 1 plus t2 sine theta 2 plus mg, and substitute all the required value, that is all the angles value, we'll get that 5 will be equal to t1 into 4 by 5, this is the value for sine theta 1, plus t2 into 3 by 5, value of sine theta 2, plus 0.3, that was the mass of that particle, into the value of g, that is 10. So we'll get that 5 is equal to 4t1 by 5 plus 3t2 by 5 plus 3. The horizontal component that was equal and opposite to each other, t1 cos theta 1 will be equal to t2 cos theta 2. The t1 into 3 by 5, this is the value for theta 1, and t2 into 4 by 5, this is the value for cos theta 2. So when we will do further, we'll get that 3t1 by 5, which will be equal to 4t2 by 5. So the value for t1 will get 4t2 by 3. After solving the vertical component equation, we will get this one, that is 2 is equal to 4t1 by 5 plus 3t2 by 5. In this equation, we'll put the value of t1, what we got before, that was 4t2 by 3. So now it will be 2 is equal to 4 by 5 into 4t2 by 3 plus 3t2 by 5. After solving this equation, we'll get the value of t2, that is 1.2 newton. Now we'll put this value of t2 in the previous equation. So we'll get the value of t1, that will be 1.6 newton. So the final answer, t1 is equal to 1.6 newton and t2 is equal to 1.2 newton. Friends, I hope you have understood this question. If you have any question about the content and any query, then you can post in comments. Thank you.